And what happened next shocked me and still rocks me to this day. So I was going to title this video Overcoming Mountains, but then I thought this is more than that, and you'll see why in a little bit. So let's see where this goes. So welcome back to my little channel, and today's video is a special one for me in particular, and as for the why, I'll get into that in a little bit. So every valley shall be raised up, every mountain and hill made low, and the glory of the Lord will be revealed. Now, when you face a mountain in your life, you have a choice: be overwhelmed or be energized, because you know that the Father will reveal himself to you in a profound way. And of course, your first thought may be, if I were really in God's will, I wouldn't be facing any obstacles, would I? Especially the ones that are as enormous as the ones that you're facing right now, or think that you're facing right now. But I want to say that it simply isn't so, because we have an enemy that will oppose us every time that the Lord does anything good for us. Now, you can be in the center of God's plan, doing exactly as he says, yet still encounter mass amounts of opposition. Now, I've been wanting to make this video for a while now, but as you know, life gets in the way, and then it just never happens. So this morning, while spending time with the Lord, I read about deliverance, and that was the little nudge that I needed to let me know that the Lord finally wants me to talk about this. See, I started smoking when I was about 14, 15 years old, and it's been my kryptonite ever since. And the fact that I suffer from chronic asthma didn't and doesn't, however you want to look at it, help me either. But I digress. And so for over 20 years, I tried stopping, and yes, I'm that old. I just couldn't kick this habit, no matter what. And if you've seen any of my other recent videos, you'd know that I have since turned my back completely on the New Age, on psychedelics, and so on. I got baptized, and I now follow Jesus Christ 100%. Now, let me tell you, the change has not been easy. It's been seriously tough. Whoever tells you that by turning away from Satan and turning to God is going to make everything easier is absolutely lying to you. It is not an easy decision. It's not an easy road, but that is why the devil's road is that wide while God's road is that narrow. But in saying that, it has been incredibly miraculous as well. Anyway, without making this video longer than it should be, let me get to the point I was trying to make on deliverance. So back to the smoking part. Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. Matthew 7 verse 7. Now God knows I have asked for the spirit of smoking, or whatever you want to call it, to be removed from my life thousands of times before, until one day when I least expected anything. This was about 2 weeks before we went into our first 21 days of hard lockdown here in South Africa, and I suddenly and violently got sick for no apparent reason. But actually, let me just backtrack for a moment. So the night before I got sick, I had a dream. Now, whenever I have a dream that's very vivid and sticks with me the next morning, there's usually something behind it. And so this is what I dreamt. So in my dream, I was laying in bed and I got woken up by my girlfriend leaning over me, pushing me down and licking my ear. As I was trying to get her to stop, there was a small container or a tin or something in front of me. And on top of this tin, there was a tobacco leaf. Anyway, so after a lot of struggling and sleep paralysis, I finally woke up. Now, as I said, I suddenly got sick. My body completely crashed. My throat felt like it was pushed through a grater, and I was incredibly nauseous. And so this started quite early in the day, but it progressively got worse and worse and worse and worse as the day went on. And so I went to lay down in the afternoon, all while this dream kept on playing in my mind over and over and over again. And I was trying to make sense of it. And then all of a sudden, I just started praying to God, asking for deliverance again from the smoking. But then I started throwing up. And so hanging over the toilet, feeling like I was about to die, I thought it was over. But then I started throwing up again. And what happened next shocked me and still rocks me to this day. Something came out of me, and it wasn't a spirit, but it was a tangible thing. It was a bone or a stick about 3 or 4 centimeters long. And the odd thing is that I don't eat red meat. I haven't had red meat for 2 years. I do chicken, but I only do chicken fillets, so I don't eat any bones, or I don't come near any bones. And so whatever it was, only God knows where it came from. And so after that, I almost immediately started feeling better and have not craved for or touched a cigarette ever since. And so I know many of you are going to think I'm crazy. Many of you are going to think that it's my subconscious playing games with me. Many of you are going to say it's coincidence. Whatever. I've heard it all, but let me tell you this. There is absolutely no doubt in my mind that God delivered me from smoking on that day. Absolutely no doubt. And I feel it's important for me to share this story with the world, purely for the fact that we find ourselves in incredibly scary times at the moment, and that there are people out there that really want deliverance in their lives, but are either too scared or don't have the faith to ask our Father for that deliverance. And so whatever it is in your life that you need deliverance from, whether it's alcohol, abuse, smoking, drugs, whatever, go on your knees and pray for it. Pray for it over and over again and as hard as you can, and know that God will deliver you from it. Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but there's no doubt that He will. And so don't focus on the mountain, my online friend. Look towards the Almighty who loves you and who provides for you. And as Matthew 21 verse 21 says, He can handle the troubles before you with ease. And if you respond correctly with faith, your relationship with Him will grow stronger and stronger, and ultimately He will be glorified. So don't give up. Look to God and trust in Him. You'll be amazed at how He levels the mountains before you. Let's pray. Lord, thank you for taking care of the mountain before me. I know that it's nothing to you. I praise you, my Savior. Amen. In His presence, watch for the Savior's deliverance. God bless.